What's up guys, this is Balash from RacingBrick. In today's video I will talk about the new generation of LEGO Speed Champions sets released in the last 3 years, and I will share 5 reasons why I think these are simply the best automotive LEGO builds you can buy today, either for yourself or as a gift for any gearhead. I will also compare them to the life-size vehicles, using some footage from a brand new game called Grid Legends, who happened to be the sponsor of this video. Check the link in the description for more details. So, let's start with a quick history lesson if you are not familiar with the Speed Champions theme. It was launched in 2015, and if you take a look at these sets, you can see they were quite different from the ones you can buy today. The basic concept was to replicate popular vehicles from different brands in a 6-stud wide format, but with all the minifigures and accessories, this was still very much a play theme aimed at kids, just like most of the other LEGO themes you know. You will quickly realize that the proportions are somewhat off. The cars are much longer than they supposed to be, and not wide enough, thanks to the 6-stud width limitation. They are usually one-seaters, with the driver sitting in the middle of the vehicle. I don't say they are totally wrong, but they look a bit like a caricature version of the real cars. They were somewhat bigger than an average city vehicle though. Here are a few examples from that era, compared to the cars that you can see in the Grid Legends game. You can definitely see the effort trying to replicate the most characteristic details of the cars, but the overall proportions were still off, unfortunately. But 2020 brought us a fundamental design change. The width of the cars was changed from 6 studs to 8 studs, and oh boy, what a huge difference that made. Way more realistic proportions, focus on the cars and not the play features, details, details, and even more details. Now let's go through those 5 reasons I promised you at the beginning. The first one, playsets became display pieces. As I mentioned previously, the design approach changed radically. In the 6-stud wide era, the sets had minifigures, lots of accessories, furniture, even simplified buildings, so it was mostly focusing on the play experience, and meanwhile the look was only secondary. The 2020 lineup kept the buildable finish lines for the double packs, and we got drivers for each vehicle, but that's all. And the other 2 generations omitted all accessories. This is the most obvious sign of the change, but there are others as well. Although these sets kept the 7+ or 8+ age recommendation, if you take a look at the cars, you can see that the philosophy changed. These sets would fit very much in LEGO's new 18+ product line since they look like brick-built diecast cars, but I'm glad the folks at LEGO did not want to confuse the younger generation. So, why do I say these are more like display pieces? Here's the second reason, realism. Just take a look at these 2 cars side by side, and you can clearly see that huge development. The Ford GT LM GTE Pro has a massive wing that's missing from the Heritage Edition, but the newer one has much better proportions. These are not the same cars, but they competed against each other. While most of the details are added with stickers on the Porsche, the Ferrari has way more brick-built details, like the vents over the front wheels or the ones next to the cockpit. And here's some comparison with the cars from Grid Legends. The Aston Martin Valkyrie AMR Pro, for example, all the details of the front splitter, the structure of the front suspension, and the fin at the rear. Interestingly, the rear wing has a different shape in the game. I don't say it's a one-to-one replica, since the wheels seem to be somewhat smaller, but it's a great build at this scale. Another one here is the Koenigsegg Jesko. I'd like to highlight again the front of the car with the lime X in the center, all the colorful accents on the sills, the brick-built ones, and the massive rear wing. Now let me tell you a few words about today's sponsor. Grid Legends is a racing game developed by Codemasters, featuring real-life circuits across the world, including San Francisco, Paris, or London. The game features more than 100 vehicles, including touring cars, semi-trailer trucks, open-wheel cars, stadium trucks, drift cars, and even electric vehicles. The game has a story mode called Driven to Glory with real-life actors, and the same virtual set tech was used for the scenes, as you could see in the Mandalorian series. For the first time in the Grid series, players will be able to create their own races and share them worldwide, including custom routes, obstacles, vehicle restrictions, and rules. Now to the next point. Excellent building experience. After building most of the Speed Champion sets from the very beginning, and all of them from the last 3 years, I can say this without the slightest hesitation. The building experience and the techniques used in these sets are one of the best, if not the best of all LEGO sets. Here is a best of compilation from my recent reviews. I like these details the most. This upside-down build connected with a clip to that hook to form the rear wheel arch. Another nice attention to detail, the black and red sticker on that hinge element along with the black 1x1 plate, they are there to make the interior of this air intake section black. The variety of different plates, wedges and other new parts make such complex surfaces possible even at this scale. Check out all the curves and layers here. The air intake is no longer a simple sticker, but it is properly built. This front section is built upside down and it is attached with tow bolts. Okay, this will actually blow your mind. First of all, the assemblies that are connected to the Technic axle hose with these totally unrelated modified run tiles. Once you connect both of them, you rotate the whole thing and boom! Perfectly aligned curved surfaces matching the edge of the car and also providing us with the iconic rear end of the car. Truly amazing! The stickers on these pieces will have some significance shortly, but first check out this innovative connection method. There's a very specific distance at the end between the pieces, matching the curve of the front fenders. This snot assembly, short for studs not on top, goes to the front of the car, and now you can check out these amazing 3D lamps with the transparent pieces and the stickers beneath them. I know it's not proportional, but I don't care. When did you expect to see the rear diffuser support cords being replicated on a Lego set at this size? I love this attention to detail. A design study of the distinctive rear light of the Vantage, red transparent toothpiece for the corner, held in place by the 1x4 plate. In the center there's a grey bracket on top of the 1x2 red tile, and between them there's this assembly with that round piece, held in place by the clip, and it is installed upside down to perfectly complement the red transparent cheese slope below it. Do you see those red round 1x1 pieces? Those clips will click on them nicely, and will support these assemblies at the correct angle, leaving just a small gap between them. Now here comes this tailpiece on the Technic pins, and if you rotate it backwards, it fits in that gap perfectly, and it will have just the exact right angle needed. So, as you see, the designers really go down to the most granular details, pushing the limits of the Lego bricks, and there's some innovative part usage in each and every set. You might think that size might be a limitation, but actually it isn't. The next point, size and variety. This size and scale seems to be a sweet spot for these vehicles. It allows the designers to add lots of details, but meanwhile keeps the piece count low and the price as well. More about that in a minute. Creator expert vehicles use similar building techniques, but they are much bigger. Bigger should be always better, right? Well, not necessarily. We get only a handful of these sets each year, like only these three last year. The Speed Champions lineup had 6 sets last year with 3 double packs, which means 9 vehicles altogether. The variety is also much bigger. Designers don't need to focus only on the most popular supercars or race cars. We had this excellent dragster in 2021, or my other favorite, the Ford Bronco. LEGO also releases other branded cars, mostly in the Technic line. How do they compare to Speed Champions? The scale has a bigger variety in Technic. As you can see, there are smaller and bigger ones as well. But besides the 3 1/8 scale supercars released so far that are much bigger, so they have more details, the rest of the lineup does not seem to be that different compared to the details found on Speed Champions sets. Here's the Ford F-150 Raptor, for example. The front and the rear is covered with stickers. If you remove those, then it would be hard to identify the truck. It's a pretty simple build, by the way, but at least it has hand of God steering for some playability. Or here's the Ferrari 488 GTE. It has more brick build details here and there, but there are also huge gaps, and it needs tons of stickers to have enough details. Yet another example is the Porsche 911 RSR. Pretty basic body shaping, lots of stickers again. You might say that Technic is about the functional features and not the look. Well, these cars in the recent years usually stop at a fake engine, suspension, and steering, which is not much. So, here's my last item on the list, price. It is also related to the variety, but if we compare recent Creator Expert or Technic cars with last year's Speed Champions lineup, you can get all 6 sets with 9 cars for a recommended retail price of $190. The Volkswagen T2 Camper Van is $180, the Porsche 911 is $150, the Ferrari 488 GT is $170, and the Ford F-150 Raptor is only $100. That's actually a good deal in the US, but not so much in Europe. So, better price, higher variety, and smaller scale means you can collect much more of these Speed Champion sets, and they really do look awesome in high quantities together. A few remarks for the end. I don't want you to think I'm a blind Speed Champions fanboy. Actually, I am. But there's still room for improvement for these sets. A lot of people don't like the huge amount of stickers, and there are even color inconsistency issues with them, but we have more printed parts on the latest sets like before, so I hope this tendency continues. Higher variety of cars means some sets won't be liked by the majority, like the Dragster, which I don't understand at all, or the Jaguar I-Pace e-Trophy. That one was actually quite blocky with two small wheels if we compare it to the original. Wheels is the next big challenge, by the way, for Speed Champions. I think it would be great to have slightly bigger and most importantly wider wheels introduced. This Ferrari desperately needed one, for example. So, please let me know your thoughts, guys, in the comments. Huge thanks again to Grid Legends for sponsoring today's video. You can check the link to the game in the description. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. I also suggest to subscribe with notifications, as more exciting content is coming soon. See you next time, bye bye.